Welcome to Vocabulary TV. This is our 30th video lesson on roots, prefixes and suffixes in English vocabulary. In this episode, we are going to cover a group of Latin roots, knock, knox and nick, which have a lot in common, and so it is best to study them together. Various words as seen hanging on the tree branches can be easily learnt using this root connection. So let's begin. Well, to explore a mythological connection to this root, Nyx or Nox, as known by Romans, was a goddess who was the personification of night. She was believed to be one of the oldest deities and was mother to several other deities, including death and sleep. So there is the proof that since ages, night has been associated with several dark things. As the goddess of the night, Nox is represented as dressed in black, and is believed to be followed by stars in her course. One of the common words that you can relate to the root knock or knox, meaning night, is the word nocturnal. The word is used mostly to describe animals or birds which are active during night. Like we know that owl is a nocturnal bird. The opposite of nocturnal is diurnal, which describes things that relate to or occur during daytime, such as diurnal tasks. Next word, which is equinox, is equally common. Made up of prefix equi, meaning equal, and nox, meaning night, the word literally stands for equal nights and refers to those dates when day and night are of equal length, which are about 22nd September and 20th March. At the equinox, the sun is overhead at the equator, and that's why days and nights are of equal duration. Next, we have the word noctilucent, and we have done word roots luc and lume earlier, and they mean light. So combining the two roots, noct and lucent, the word noctilucent describes something that is visible or glowing at night. Like you can see in this picture that in the night sky, there are noctilucent clouds. And again, an easy one, we have the word noctambulant. In this word, we have suffixed the root amble, meaning to walk, with our base root, and the word we get is noctambulant. It describes someone who walks by night and could very well describe a thief or a rogue who walks and carries out his activities by night. But since at night people are supposed to be asleep, so the more general meaning in which it is used now is that of a sleepwalker. Another word for which is somnambulism. Moving on to some notions associated with night, the word root also means harm or harmful, and the first instance of such a meaning is the word noxious. Noxious describes something that is harmful, poisonous, or very unpleasant. Like we can say that poisonous ivy is a noxious weed, as it is known to cause rashes on skin. Another example could be that of gases such as carbon monoxide, which are known to be noxious. And as you can see in this picture, the person is feeling sick because of the noxious chemical fumes. On the contrary, we have the word innocent. If we add the prefix in, meaning not, to nocent, we get the word innocent, which literally means not harming or not hurting. And the first image that comes to your mind for the word innocent are perhaps infants or babies who you know can never harm you. And indeed, there are several meanings in which this word is used, which closely reflect the literal meaning. If we say he is an innocent who was sentenced for a life term, innocent here means not guilty of a crime or offense. In another sentence, an innocent pedestrian was knocked down to death by a speeding Mercedes car. The second meaning of innocent comes into play, which is not responsible for or directly involved in an event, yet suffering its consequences. But most commonly, innocent refers to someone like a baby who is free from moral wrong and is not corrupted. The fourth meaning in which we can use this word is harmless or not intended to cause harm. For example, it was nothing but an innocent mistake on the part of the clerk who penned down the figure as Rs. 10,000 instead of Rs. 1 lakh. Yet another word which has a similar derivation as that of innocent is the word innocuous, which means not injurious or not harmful. As a metaphorical extension of the idea of injury, innocuous can also be used to indicate that someone or something does not cause hurt feelings or even strong feelings, as in the phrase an innocuous book or innocuous issues. So to summarize, something that is harmless and inoffensive can be described as innocuous. Like, look at this picture of the cowardly lion from the movie The Wizard of Oz. It looks pretty harmless, isn't it? I can aptly describe it as an innocuous creature. Or let's hear out the comment from a husband to his wife on the dinner table. Honey, did you forget to add salt in the dish today? It's pretty tasteless. And as you can guess, at this remark, which was seemingly innocuous, the wife could easily take offense. Next, we have the word obnoxious, which literally means towards harm. But over time, this word got influenced by the word noxious, and in contemporary English, obnoxious refers to someone or something who or which is extremely unpleasant, especially in a way that makes people feel offended, annoyed, or disgusted. Like an obnoxious smell coming out of one's shoes or an obnoxious person. Then we have the word nuisance, which has journeyed all the way from Latin to French to English and retains the original sense of hurt or harm in its meaning. Nuisance describes a person, thing, or situation that is annoying or that causes trouble or problems, like a neighbor who drops in on you several times a day with petty requests, can be described as a nuisance. An example sentence for the word would be, for the babysitter, having all those naughty kids running around the house was such a nuisance. Moving on to words which are darker in meaning, we have the word base Nikru, which means death. Can you recall the goddess Nyx and the part about death being one of her offspring? There are several words starting with Nikru which have this meaning of death reflected in them, like necromancy, which is supposedly the practice of communicating with the dead, especially in order to predict the future. In general, it is known as witchcraft, sorcery, or black magic. Then there is the word necropolis, which literally means a city of the dead, and refers to a cemetery, especially a large one, belonging to an ancient city. There is necrology, which can stand for an obituary notice or a list of deaths. And the medical condition called necrosis, which means the death of most of or all the cells in an organ or tissue due to disease, injury, or failure of blood supply. But perhaps two words that I would like to highlight, as they are extremely important and one of the most popular ones, they are the words pernicious and internecine. And in both of them, the base root takes the spelling NIC or NEC, meaning death, ruin, or to kill. Pernicious, for example, literally means something causing ruin or destructive. Pernicious describes a thing or a phenomenon which has a harmful effect, especially in a gradual or subtle way, something which is deadly and extremely evil. For example, excessive smoking is known to have a pernicious influence on one's body. And finally, let's discuss the word internecine. The word is derived from the prefix inter, meaning among, and nicare, meaning to kill. So internecine literally means to kill among and describes a state involving conflict within a group, something which is mutually destructive or destructive to both sides in a conflict. Look at the picture here. It is the best illustration I could find for the word. And as you can see, the first person is piercing a dagger through his opponent's head, and the second one is firing a shot in the first person's head. This conflict is mutually destructive. That is to say, it is internecine. An example sentence would be, notwithstanding the fact that they were previously accomplices in several crimes, the two gangsters had several ego issues and found themselves engaged in an internecine conflict. Now test your understanding of the words learnt in this lesson by filling in the blanks below. It is recommended that you pause the video when the timer starts. And that brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.